continuation to previous video, I'm again taking one example of one more distance time graph showing non-uniform motion. So this is distance and this is your time axis. I am taking distance in meters and time in seconds. So let us see that the division on time axis as 2 second, 4 second, 6 second, 8 second, 10 second, and so on. And here we have distance as 5 meter, 10 meter, 15 meter, 20 meter, 25 meter, and so on. And suppose if we are getting a graph like this. So see, what if our graph is starting from this axis, it means that when time is zero, the distance or object is already at 5 meter from us. The position of object is, object, suppose if I am standing somewhere here, so object is already, this object is already at a distance of 5 meter from me. Okay, so here distance is at 0 second, distance is already at 5 meter. Now see, in first 2 seconds, it is almost at 5 meter, or you can say a very slight change in position is there. At 4 second, it is at approximately 10 meter. Then at 6 second, it is at approximately 20 meter. Then at 8 second, you have to see about 8 seconds, so we can say it is above 25 meter. So see, in first 2 seconds, approximately one meter distance, or let it be at a 6 meter. So at in first 2 seconds, here I am again taking time and here distance. So in first 2 seconds, the distance travel is from 5 to 6 meter, means only 1 meter distance object has traveled in first 2 seconds. Then in when the time is 4 seconds, the distance is 10 meters. So at 4 seconds, the distance covered by the object is the position of the object is at 10 meter. And at 6 seconds, it is at 20 meter. So at 6 seconds, it is at 20 meter. So in first, let it be at 6 meter. Instead, in place of saying 1 meter, we will take the position, we are taking position, so let it be 6 meter. Then 4 second, 10 meter. Then 6 second, 20 meter. Then 8 second, at 8 second, so it is above 20, somewhere near about 30 or 35. Okay, so it is above 35. So if we talk about these 2 seconds, first 2 seconds, if you see this distance traveled, there is only, it is off from 5 meter to 6 meter, so only 1 meter distance is traveled in first 2 seconds. Then 2 to 4 seconds, the time is 2 seconds only. And if we talk about the distance, now the distance traveled is near about 4 meter. In next 2 seconds, from 4 to 6, distance traveled is, again time is 2 seconds, but the distance traveled is 10 to 20 meter, means it is starting from 10 meter and reaching at a position of 20 meter. So this is at 10 meter. So see, in first 2 seconds, it has traveled only 1 meter. In next 2 seconds, it has traveled 4 meter. In next 2 seconds, it has traveled 10 meters. It means that object is not covering equal distance in equal interval of time. So we say that here the motion is non-uniform. Why the motion is non-uniform? Just see from the graph once again. In first 2 seconds, it is covering a distance of only 1 meter. In again, the gap is of 2 seconds, but the distance covered is 4 meter. In next 2 seconds, the distance covered is 10 meters. So every time in equal interval of time, the distance covered is not equal. It means that object follows a non-uniform motion. So if we are getting a distance time graph in this way, it may start from this axis or it may start from this axis, any kind of graph. If we are getting, suppose if we are getting such a graph, again the object follows non-uniform motion, any kind of shape. If we have, suppose this type of shape, again the motion is non-uniform in nature. So again, giving a quick review, if we are having distance time graph in this way, where your distance time graph is parallel to time axis, then object is at rest. If we are getting a straight line with some slope to time axis, then it is uniform motion. If we are getting any curved line like this or this or this, then the motion of the object is non-uniform in nature. Now we will discuss few of the numericals based on these graphs.